Good day, dear students. I am Pinky Suhail, your science teacher of class 5. Welcome to another class of science. Students, today we will learn about inertia and simple machines from Oxford Reading Book. Book pages 71 till 77. Students, this is part 2. Students, before starting today's topic, I will give you quick review of previous part. In previous part, we have learned about force, friction, and gravity. What is force? A force is a push or a pull. Force can change the speed, direction, or shape of an object. What is friction? Friction is the resistance to motion of one object moving relative to another. What is gravity? Gravity is the force which pulls things towards each other or the center of the earth. Students, in this part, we will learn about what is inertia. Simple machines, lever and its kinds, and uses of lever in daily life. First, we will learn about inertia. What is inertia? Inertia is that an object will remain in motion or at rest unless it is acted upon by a force. What is inertia? Inertia is the tendency of a body to resist a change in motion or rest. For example, when traveling in a train or any other vehicle, have you noticed how you continue to move forward when it stops? When a vehicle stops, you tend to jerk towards before coming to a complete stop. In the same way, you will jerk backwards when the vehicle begins to move, which means objects tend to keep on doing what they are doing unless disturbed. Students, now we will move on to another topic, that is simple machine. Simple machine makes work easier for us by allowing us to push or pull over increased distance. Simple machines are those machines that have few or no moving parts at all. So students, simple machines are tools used to make work easier. Now, compound machines. A compound machine is a machine in which two or more simple machines have been put together. For example, a stapler. The top arm of stapler is lever. When you push down on this lever, it transfers energy into a staples. The staples in a stapler are wedges. When you push down on a stapler, it sends out a sharp metal staples. Examples of compound machines you can see on your screen: cycle, shovels, and wheelbarrow are the examples of compound machines. Now, kinds of simple machines. Students, simple machines has 6 types. Number 1, screw. Number 2, pulley. Number 3, wheel and axle. Number 4, wedge. Number 5, inclined plane. And number 6, lever. Wheel and axle. A rod called axle is fitted with a wheel to create a wheel and axle arrangement. The wheel becomes a simple machine when combined with an axle. For example, doorknob, cycle pedal, and screwdriver are the examples of wheel and axle. You can see on your screen the examples of wheel and axles are cycle pedal, doorknob and screwdriver. Now pulley. This simple machine is made up of a rope and a wheel. In a pulley, an effort can be applied in one direction and a load can be moved in another direction. A pulley is used to do twice as much work with the same method. For example, well and crane are the examples of pulley. You can see in picture, well and crane are the examples of pulley. Inclined plane. An inclined plane is a slope over which a load can be easily pushed up or rolled down. You can see the picture in the picture. Heavy objects can be moved more easily from a lower to a higher level with the help of an inclined plane. For example, hospital ramp and winding road are the good examples of inclined plane. You can see in your picture, winding road and hospital ramp. Screw. The circular motion of a screw helps to move things upward and downward. A screw holds things together through a longer distance with a stronger grip. Wedge. Two inclined planes join together to form a sharpened edge. The wedge is the active twin of inclined plane and one of the six classical simple machines. Knife and axe are the examples of wedge. You can see in your picture. Knife and axe are the examples of wedge. What is lever? A lever is basically a long stick that you push or pull against a fulcrum or pivot to move something. What is lever? A lever is basically a long stick that you push or pull against a fulcrum or pivot to move something. In order to lift an object by hand, force is required. When you lift this object without applying muscular force, if we use a lever. A lever essentially has three parts. You can see in the picture, a lever has three parts: effort, load, and fulcrum or pivot. Effort, we can say force also, load, fulcrum or pivot. Effort is the point where force is applied. Effort is the point where force is applied. Load is the point where you want the force applied to act. And pivot or fulcrum. Fulcrum is the fixed support. Kinds of lever. Students, there are three kinds of lever: first class lever, second class lever and third class lever. First class lever. The first class group of lever includes scissors and pliers. The effort force is at one end, the pivot is in the middle, and the load is at the other end. look at this, load, fulcrum or pivot, or force. Seesaw and nail cutter are the another good examples of first class group of lever. Seesaw and nail cutter are the examples of first class lever. Second class lever. The second class group of lever includes the wheelbarrow. The effort force is at one end, the pivot is at the other end, and the load is in the middle. You can see load is in the middle, force is here, fulcrum or pivot is another end. Nutcracker and lemon squeezer are the examples of the second class group of lever. Look at the pictures. Lemon squeezer and nutcracker are the examples of second class group of lever. Third class lever. In third class lever, the effort force is in the middle. The effort force is in the middle between the load and pivot. Between the load and pivot, effort force is in the middle. The effort force is more than the load force, but the effort travel distance is less. These are the examples. Tweezers, kitchen tongs are the examples of third class group of lever. Uses of lever in daily life. Students, a lever usually is used to move or lift objects. Sometimes it is used to push against objects, but not actually move them. Lever can be used to exert a large force over a small distance at one end by exerting only a small force over a greater distance at the other. These are the examples of lever. Examples of lever in everyday life includes wheelbarrows, scissors, pliers, bottle openers, mops, brooms, nutcrackers, and sports equipments like baseball, baseball bats, golf clubs, and hockey sticks. Even your arm can act as a lever. These are the examples of lever: scissors, nutcracker, nail clipper, tongs, wheelbarrow, and seesaw. Student, it is time to get your home task. You can see on your screen there are four questions. Question number one is, what is inertia? Write the example of inertia. Question number two, define simple machines. Write the names of simple machines. Question number three, draw and label the load, effort, and pivot on pair of scissors. Question number four, draw the basic diagrams of kinds of lever. Student, notes for you. Do all the homework given to you from the first lesson till the present one in your copy. Marks will be given to you on the basis of your homework and activities. Students, you should protect yourself and others from COVID-19. Okay, student, thank you. God bless you all.